Estonians are modest by nature and don't tend to brag about their achievements, either big or small. But that doesn't mean they don't leave their mark. There are quite a few figurative Estonian footprints left here on British soil.
My name is George Fletcher, and I'm a British actor. At the end of World War II, my grandparents fled from Estonia to the United Kingdom, and while I've always known about my Estonian heritage, I now want to know more. So, I'm on a mission to find the Estonian footprints here in the UK.
Let's go back to the beginning of the 20th century, when London was the largest city in the world, and the strongest man in the world was Estonian-born George Hackenschmidt. George Hackenschmidt moved to the UK in 1903. During his heavyweight wrestling career, which spanned between 1898 and 1911, he fought in around 3,000 matches, losing only two of them. Crowds loved him, and in the 1930s, US President Franklin Roosevelt said, "If I wasn't president of the United States, I'd want to be George Hackenschmidt."
Now, there is an Estonian with a connection to a head of state much closer to home. Mr. Ernest J. Collis's expertise in French patisserie was second to none, and that made him a firm favorite of London elites in the 1920s. After migrating to the UK in 1911 and having worked at the best hotels and the finest luxury ships at the time, Mr. Ernest J. Collis was hired to be head patissier at King George VI's coronation in 1937. Looking at his book, The Complete Patissier, which he wrote after the coronation, I think if the Great British Bake Off had been around in the 1930s, Mr. Ernest J. Collis could easily have been the Paul Hollywood of his time. Speaking of television, let's jump forward in time and to a subject very close to my heart, of acting. Mary Tam was born in Bradford in 1950 to an Estonian and Russian refugee family. She left the drama school RADA in 1971 and clocked up a string of credits in British household favourites, such as Coronation Street, EastEnders and Casualty, to name just a few. But it was in 1978 when she played her way into the hearts of sci-fi fans with her role as Romana in the legendary series Doctor Who, next to Tom Baker.
Speaking of playing your way into people's hearts, for nearly 20 years, Estonian ballet dancers Agnes Oaks and Thomas Edder were the principal performers of the English National Ballet. So much so, they were even dubbed the sweetheart couple by Queen Elizabeth II. Their long career has been acknowledged with a Laurence Olivier Award for outstanding achievement in dance. And in 2010, the pair received a CBE from the Queen herself, Commander of the Order of the British Empire.
As an avid Arsenal supporter, I cannot deny one of the great goalkeepers in the noughties, Mart the Puminator Poom. Mart joined Portsmouth in 1994 before making his Premier League debut in 1997 for Derby County. But it was when he moved to Sunderland in 2003 that Mart wrote his name in the English football history books. In the dying minutes of his first game, Mart scored the best goal a goalkeeper has ever scored in the Premier League. He was cheered on by both Derby County fans and Sunderland fans alike. He joined Arsenal, playing in the stadium just behind me, and then Watford before retiring in 2009.
All these great Estonians are merely the tip of the iceberg. There are so many, many footprints that have been left here, but there are also the footprints being left right now. I'm off to go meet Sirley Reitmar, whose work as a photographer here in the UK has not gone unnoticed.
What's it like to be an Estonian artist elsewhere? You know, do you feel like your identity as an Estonian informs your work?
I don't identify myself as a specifically... No, I am Estonian. Mm. I know I am Estonian. I'm not trying to be somebody else. Estonians are kind of like chameleons. If they move somewhere, in another country, I think they really blend in really quickly.
I saw the work that you did with your mother, which was shown at the National Portrait Gallery, if that's right. What's it like to work with her?
She's giggling, she's laughing, she's waiting for the next shoot. She's having fun trying all the costumes on. So as long as it's fun, I think we'll just keep going.
Thank you so much for joining me on this journey.
I found it absolutely fascinating, and I've met so many amazing people and learned so much, especially about my own Estonian roots. But I feel like I've just started to really scratch the surface. There are currently about 15,000 Estonians living here in the UK, contributing to British society and leaving behind their own unique Estonian footprints.